you.
Welcome back to the Curly Bookworm. I'm Shibani. If you're new here, you should know that we talk about books here and it's super fun. Apparently, Mogul really likes being in my videos these days. I think that she has a plan to overtake this channel. I'm not really sure. If she does overtake it, you guys, I love you. I miss you. And just understand that it's an evil cat plan about world dominion. Maybe she heard me, that's why she left. Anyway, so today's video is about the books that I've DNF'd. Recently, I found myself doing a discussion video about why I DNF books and why I kind of don't finish them and how I have like no guilt about it at all. I'm gonna link it here. You can take a look at it. But after that video, I got a bunch of requests on my different social media where people basically said, let me know what you actually have DNF'd in the past. So to make it easier, I'm not going to talk about everything that I've ever DNF'd because we don't have that much time. I'll talk about maybe like 6 or 8 months, the stuff that I've read and decided not to go on with. This video is essentially categorized in two pieces. One is books that I haven't finished and the other one is series that I haven't finished. So let's start with the books that I haven't finished recently. The first one and the biggest one on my list is The Captive Prince by C.S. Basket. This one was so hard. So my reading buddy and friend Prasanna read this book after I described it to her and she said it's really good. But here's the thing. This book is about this prince who basically gets taken hostage and he is sort of given away to another sort of enemy state and he becomes like a slave there. Nobody knows who he is. It's a dystopian world and that was fine. It was okay. I didn't mind the book or the setup or the characters. What I did definitely mind was the violence in this book. It started from here and then went all the way there and I was like, dude, this is a lot of violence. There was a lot of rape, there was a lot of pedophilia, there was a lot of, I don't know, I mean, it just, and it's not even like they condemned any of it. They were talking about it as if this is the way the world is and the way the world is created, and somehow I couldn't endorse it, I couldn't read it, so I totally DNF'd it post like maybe 70-80 pages because I realized that it's just not, I can't do it. Another book that I want to talk about here is An Abundance of Catherines by John Green. Yes, this is the same author that wrote Fault in Our Stars, everybody's favorite, including mine. But this book was just boring. That's all it was. So this book is about a boy who basically has dated only Catherines. For some strange reason, it so happens that every single girl that he's ever dated is named Catherine. And that's it. That's all this book is about. I read like 100 pages of this book and the writing, just something about it turned me off. The premise was super interesting, but everything else seemed really boring. The story, everything. Does this mean I will not pick up any other books by John Green? No, I don't think so. Because I've heard from a whole bunch of people that this book is particularly an exception and that there are other books by John Green that don't necessarily go down this route. So yeah. The next book that I want to talk about is The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer by Michelle Hodkin. This one was just treacherous. My experience with this book was terrible, okay? So what happened was I had heard about this book and so I downloaded a sample of it on my Kindle. It sounded super intriguing. It starts off with a bunch of kids who are basically looking at the Ouija board and they're like calling spirits and whatever. And they ask a question and then the board basically predicts that everybody's going to die. And the next thing you know, the next scene, a whole bunch of people are dead except for Mara Dyer. And then her family decides to move. And that's basically all there is that is nice to the story. Because the minute they move, she moves into a school where she sees a beautiful boy who is really fair and he has shining eyes. Does that sound familiar to you? It sounds familiar to me. That's Twilight. And that boy is Edward. No, I'm not even kidding. This author didn't even innovate on how she introduces the boy. He was in the hallway just like he was in Twilight. And I was just like, dude, that's not what I signed up for. I didn't buy this book so I could read this, so I immediately stopped reading it because it totally turned me off. Because once the move happens, you need to actually buy the book and the sample ends there. So I bought the book and the first scene was this stupid, freaking unoriginal scene and it just pissed me off. So I was just like, no, I'm not doing this, man. No. So the next book that I want to talk about is Bronze The Bronze Horseman by what happened there? Totally spazzed out. Okay, so the next book that I want to talk about is The Bronze Horseman by Paulina Simmons. This book is a historical fiction book. It is set in Russia. It tells the story of Tatiana and Alex, who fall in love against the backdrop of Russia being invaded by the infamous Hitler, and what happens thereafter. So I think I got through like 40%, 30% of this book. It's not nice. This is one of those books in my DNF list where it wasn't exceptional. And so I genuinely just got bored and quit halfway through this book. I mean, there wasn't a real solid, I hate this book kind of a reason. So this one's unique like that. But yeah, I don't know. I couldn't go on with it because it was just boring. And I feel like it's reached that point in time where I think I've DNF'd it. Though in my mind, I keep saying maybe I'll go back to it one day. Maybe, you know, like if I'm stranded on an island with my Kindle. I don't know. But at this point, it's totally DNF'd, I think. I think it's safe to say it has been DNF'd. Okay, so let's move on to the second category, which is basically a bunch of books which are part of series that I did not and will not finish. The first one is A Darker Shade of Magic by V.E. Schwab. This one is set in a bunch of different Londons, and it is a dystopian world, and there's a man who can travel between the different Londons. I liked this book. I can even barely remember it right now. I liked it, but I didn't love it. And for me, if I'm committing to like three books of the same genre, I would like for it to be at least a four. I mean, I'm never gonna continue with anything under a 4 out of 5 stars to like go on from like book 1 to 2 to 3, because there are too many books in the world. And so yeah, this one didn't pass my over 4 criteria. I think I'd rated it like a 3 on 5, which is good, but it's not good enough for me to continue. The next book is Traitors Played by Sebastian de Castell. I read this earlier this year. I had a lot of expectations of this book, and I thought it was nice. I mean, it was a really funny book, so that saved that. But the story and the writing was really limited. The world building was especially limited. So yeah, it was a nice book, but there's no way that I'm gonna waste time sort of going on to the series in this book. The next book is Cinder by Marissa Meyer. This one is super popular, and I know everybody who has read it loves this series. These are a bunch of series that are set in the future, and they're sort of retellings of different things like Cinderella and Snow White and so on and so forth. I think there are 4 books in this series. I've only read Cinder, and I know that there's not too much connection between these books. I read the first one, which is Cinder, and I liked it, but I did not love it again. Not enough anyway for me to sort of pick up the second book. I think that sort of is like a theme with series where I'm like, yeah, you know, I liked it, but I didn't love it. The next book that I want to talk about is one that I've actually done a review of, which I'll link here. This is Three Dark Crowns by Kendare Blake. This one really super disappointed me. This is not I liked it but I didn't love it category. This is I just did not like it at all. This one had a great premise. It was about an island that was ruled by women, and there were princesses who were sisters, and they had to fight each other to the death in order to win the crown. And this happened every, I don't know, like a few years, like maybe every 16, 20, 30 years. But see, the reason why I don't know is because the world building was so, so poor, and you don't really have answers to like how often does this happen, how long does each princess or queen rule for, what is the role of the king. Apart from which, the characters were like mad boring. The ending was interesting, and that's literally like 5 pages that were interesting about the book. So I'm totally DNFing this series. I'm not reading any more of this book. So that is all of the books that I've DNFed in the very recent past. I'm gonna go now. I have to get to work. In the meanwhile, please make sure that you subscribe to this channel. Leave comments here for me that tell me what books you've DNFed recently and for what reason. I would love to know, because if I agree with the reasons, then I'll probably not pick up those books myself. So I would really appreciate those comments. Please like this channel, share this channel, and all of that jazz. I will see you soon. Bye bye.